Blackthorn could fix it.
Take care, Clive. You go.
One day, I want to see all the way.
You give that rotten sod exactly what he deserves.
And how may I assist you today? My congratulations, Clive. Nevertheless, Hugo Kupka wants your head, Clive. Do try not to oblige him. Ah, my favorite pupil. One must understand one's place in the world. Very good.
We must be ready to leave the Rosalith at a moment's notice.
I trust you wrapped up warm.
Fortify the castle gates.
At once.
Hugo and his men have been busy. They've already breached the castle's outer wall. The Imperials are holding the ground for now, but it's only a matter of time before the keep falls. Those fuckers really went to town on this place. Almost like they want to wipe it off the map.
Just a means to an end.
All this for one man? They didn't have to go so far.
If you keep your wits about you, I reckon you can make it up to the castle without raising the alarm. I'll sniff out any townsfolk who haven't escaped yet and send them on their way.
Be careful.
Likewise. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Ha ha ha!
I thought I was ready for this, but...
I know. It's like a nightmare. This was our home. Come on, Clive. We have to keep going. He'll stop at nothing, Clive. Nothing.
Why? Why do this?
Clive, we can get through here.
I yield!
Look what we have here.
Gentlemen!
Boy.
once.
Take him!
I'm hurt.
get him!
Remember, we take him alive.
Set her loose!
They have a curl.
Attack!
Ready?
What do you think?
To me, boy.
Go, Torkoal!
Nice try.
Jill!
We meet at last, Sid. Or should I say, Lord Rosfield? I've been looking for you for a very long time.
Let her go, Kuka.
I'm so glad you accepted my invitation. I went to some trouble with the decorations. Do you like what I've done with the place?
Bastard!
Such a pity your predecessor couldn't join us, but I am sure you will prove compelling company. Be still, little snowflake. I would not have you melt before your starring moment. Now, on to the festivities.
That's just great, that is. I suppose it's up to me, then.
Headsman!
Where do you want me?
You! Bring the prisoner!
Yes, no more than she deserves for getting into bed with an outlaw.
Wish you'd get into mine.
Lord Kupka commands your presence.
You're to bear witness to the girl's execution.
Such a waste.
Gav! Shh!
Chris crystal fetters are a bastard to open, just so you know. Don't worry, I'll have them off before you can blink.
Where's Jill?
In the courtyard.
Shit. We have to hurry.
The Imperials have sounded the retreat and cleared out of the castle, but the place is still swarming with Kupka's men.
Leave them to me.
I'll make my way up top and circle round the back. Quick as you like, eh? Nearly forgot.
Hold on, Jill. I'm coming. I have to get to the courtyard. You let her die.
I hope you've got a plan, Clive, because we are fucked if you don't.
Can you stand?
Come, Lord Rosfield. Don't tell me you tire of my entertainment.
Enough!
Yes. Perhaps it is time we served the main repast. I trust you are hungry!
Need this?
Much obliged.
Stay close. We're getting out of here. And Togul, thank you.
Care to explain what the fuck your job just did?
Later, everyone. With me. That includes you, Togul.
Nice try. It's over.
For now. But I bet that wasn't the last of them. And they won't stop hunting us until Kupka's dead. So you get in there and finish the job, eh?
Go on. If they come again, we'll hold them back.
All right. But be careful.
Took our home, Clive. Don't let him take yours. Jill'll be safe with me. I promise.
Don't worry about us. Go.
Ah!
die by my hand. Trouble on the way.
Just enjoying your entertainment.
How gratifying. Have you come to defend your father's throne, Lord Rosfield? The Grand Duchy of Rosaria. A realm without a ruler. An army, even a people, a veritable kingdom of dust. Truly, I see no throne to defend.
No!
Enough of your games, Kupka. Just tell me what you want.
Sid's head in a box. Imagine my disappointment when I learned that he met his end at the hand of another. And my relief to learn that you had taken up his thrice-damned name.
Your master slew Benedicta Harmon and defiled her body. If you choose to bear that murderer's name, then you shall answer for his crimes.
The only crimes I shall answer for are my own. Sid did everything in his power to save that woman, though she was long past saving. And so I did what he couldn't. It was me all along, Hugo.
It was you. You killed her.
I did.
Then I am fortunate indeed. I had thought the most I could wish for was to take the life of one he loved, just as he did to me. But it seems I was wrong. And I shall have my revenge. We shared a dream! I would be the king of the world! She would be my queen! And together, we would rule like the gods we are! But you crushed that dream, grounded into dust! Hear me, Rosfield! You will pay for what you've done. I'll tear you apart with my hands!
And what of you? How many people have you killed? How many dreams have you crushed? You're not the only one who's seen their world fall apart around them. You'll get no pity from me, Kupka.
no pity, and no mercy.
The world has chosen. I am in my element. There's no escape. The earth will always be my domain.
Thank you.
Murs!
There, there. You mustn't get yourself worked up.
Wait!
Another time, Muthos.
Is that all of them?
I think so.
Well, Ludus scum. Who the fuck invited them? Not that that's the biggest surprise we've had today. Where did you learn to do that, Torgle? Not telling, eh? Suit yourself.
Gav, we have to find Clive.
Right, sorry.
You missed one.
We were worried.
So was I. I was so close. If it hadn't been for my gift, I would have finished him.
I'm just glad you got out of there alive.
When did the Royalists arrive?
Right after you went inside. Just when we thought we were shot of Titan's lot. In pile Odin's. Not enough of them to worry us, though.
No. You didn't see the one who took Kukra away.
So, what? You think they came here to save him? I'll be fucked if I know what's going on, but every minute we spend racking our brains, that bastard's getting further away. So what do?
We go back to the hideaway. I'm too tired to think. As are you, by the looks of it. After what Jill's been through. Let's worry about Kukka later, shall we?
Aye. All right. We'll give us a chance to solve the riddle of your magic mud, too. Hey, how you feeling? Ready to go home?
Just look at the state of you. You're more of a wreck than this place. Is this what you call taking better care of yourself? No more excuses, your ladyship. I order you to rest.
Fine. I'll rest.
Don't worry, Gav. She's in good hands.
But we should have never let her fall into Hugo's. Back when he had some like. The question is, where is he now?
And what the hell were those royalists doing there?
I was wondering about that all the way home.
Otto may have heard something. I'll talk to him.
And I'll talk to Tomes.
The Lawsman? About what?
About your faithful hound, for a start. If any four-legged friend's ever done that before, I'm betting Tomes will have read about it. But what I want to know is, what happens afterwards? It's all well and good Torgal saving our arses, but if it costs him what it costs Jill...
Right. Let me know if you learn anything.
Will do. And you do the same, eh?
Jill. Listen to Taya.
I will. Thank you.
Visiting hours are over, Your Lordship.
I'll be all right, Clive. I just need some rest.
Blackthorn may be the manliest of men, but he does lack a certain tenderness. Goots, meanwhile, is as burly as a behemoth, but as innocent as a babe in arms.
You look just like a princess! And you look like the princess's sister!
Thank you, Cid, for coming back to us. You're the glue keeping this place together.
Shouldn't you be getting some rest, Cid? From what I heard, you earned it.
Cid's gonna chop off Kupka's head this time.
Yeah, he won't like that.
See you, Cid. Lovely weather, isn't it? I feel like all the gods in the heavens are smiling down on us.
All right, Cid. We were starting to worry about you.
I hear your scout made quite a hero of himself over in Rosalith. Sniffing out a score of terrified townspeople and ushering them to safety. Or so he claims.
Rosalith, weren't you? Must be hard, hearing what became of the place.
No, the capital's as strange to me as I am to her. It was a lifetime ago I last set foot in the city.
How's it coming along?
Nearly there. Just need to get these last boards nailed on.
Fragrance. Anyone would think Nigel was growing himself a rose garden.
Its sap is a salve for burns and blisters, but it favors chalky soil.
Thank you for your help, Cid. The Morganbeards have taken to our little garden splendidly.
That's the spirit, Kenneth. Stretch out those branches.
Mr. Seagull. Or should I call you Mr. Lake Gull?
Back, are you? What do you want?
It's all right. Cid has nothing to fear from Kupka. He'll deal with him.
I hope you're right.
I'd never see you again.
What can I get you, Cid? Don't be a stranger, Cid.
Oh, Maeve knows how to brew a bitter, all right.
Van's newest dick.
Wise soldiers with their ruby stain. Stick steeds fed to the fire. Shall never burn away the pain. Till one man tops the pyre.
For books about Torgal. I know. Let's write one.
Torms is going to look into what happened to Torgal for us. You make sure he's not hurting himself doing, well, whatever the fuck it is he did.
Is there something I might assist you with, Clive?
I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. You wish to study the tomes? Welcome, Clive.
Jill looked white as a sheet when it was.
Little uns have been up to their old tricks again. Drawing on the Deccans.
Not all of the noble came out alive. Kupka and his men had their fun with more than a few.
None of the Empress's favourites, though. They all got away safe and sound.
My favorite pupil. Allow me to educate you. Study it well, Clive. Yes, perhaps a little revision might not go amiss. Thus ends today's lesson.
Is now a good time?
It's not a bad one. How's Duke doing?
She's been better. Ty is making sure she gets the rest she needs.
Good.
Any word on Kupka's movements?
Vivian's doing what she can to try and track him, but she's feeding on scraps. We've sent owls out to the Cursebreakers and our other friends in the West, asking them to keep their eyes peeled for anything unusual. No leads yet. But it's only a matter of time.
Right. Let me know when you find something.
There he is. All right, Clive. Still busy saving the world.
Mid. When did you get back?
Just now.
What about your studies?
Adjourned. Since Hugo Kupka invaded Rosaria. All the canvas in uproar about it. He's gone mad. He's turned rogue. It'll be us next. You try concentrating with all of that.
All right. You win.
How long will you be staying this time?
Don't know. A while, most likely. Any road, while I'm here, I was hoping you could do us a favor.
Mid, you can't just expect me to...
Please, oblige her. While we are busy tracking down Kupka, you should have a little time to spare.
Professor! Now there's a face I haven't seen in a while. Shouldn't you have it buried in a dusty old tome?
I did, till a familiar trill pricked my ears. As ever, your exuberance is a breath of fresh air, which successfully scattered the painstakingly assembled fragments of my thoughts.
I'll take that as a compliment. Well, Clive, you heard the professor. So, I'll meet you in the storeroom when you're done.
Wait, hold on! Breath of fresh air. Bloody tempest, more like.
Oi, Otto, you got my gill.
Huh? What are you on about?
My fee for bringing Mid across. She said you were paying.
That little...
The storeroom, was it? I wonder what Mid's plotting.
And how may I assist you today?
What is it that you wish to learn? The state of the realm is ever-changing.
Here for another of my lectures.
We met under curious circumstances. Naturally. Still. Then I bid you good day.
Yeah. What's everyone whispering about?
Haven't you heard? Mid's back. Things are about to get interesting around here.
Hours are over, Your Lordship.
I'll be all right, Clive. I just need some rest.
Thank you, Cid, for coming back to us.
You look just like a
princess. Keeping this place together.
You took your time.
I'm a busy man, Mid.
I'll get to the point then. I want to turn the room down there into a workshop like the one I had at Dad's place.
Mid, you've only just come back.
And? I've been thinking about it for a while. Dad said I had a knack for engineering. Told me everything he knew about it. Then sent me off to Canva to learn everything he didn't. That was his dream for me. That one day I'd put my studies to use for the good of the cause. But I'm helping no one stuck at school. I've studied enough. It's time I put my knack to work. I know that I can help the people here, and I want to do it.
Well, well, well. If Sid could see you now. All right. I'll tell Otto you'll be staying.
I knew you'd say yes. Which is why I wrote up a list of jobs for you.
For me?
Who else?
What do you want me to do?
First things first, I need equipment and materials to start making my own. There's the design to the stuff I need and the stuff it needs smithing from. The other materials I can work myself. Just need a generous benefactor to lay them on for me. Apart from the wood, I'll need a carpenter for that, but I can just borrow yours.
Is that everything?
For now. I'll let you know if I need anything else.
Start. Materials and tools. That means Karen and Blackthorn.
Basically, I need a smith, a merchant, and someone who can work wood. And let's face it, my student allowance ain't gonna stretch that far. So do us a favor, will ya?
Nearly there. Just need to get these last boards nailed on.
Blackthorn, you busy?
What's it look like?
I have a commission for you, from Mid. She requires certain tools. Do you think you can make them?
Bloody hell. What's she planning to build with this stuff? An airship? I'll see what I can do. Till I bring them over when I'm done.
My thanks. And Mid's, no doubt.
Was wondering where you'd got to. Mid's back from Canva. Have you seen her?
Just now. She's planning to set up a workshop in the stores and ask me to buy her some materials. Here's the list. Think you can find everything on there?
This lot. Won't be much of a trader if I couldn't.
Excellent. As for payment...
It's paid. 100 times over by what that girl's done for us. If it weren't for her filters, we'd have nought to drink but blight water, and that would have drained the life out of us long ago.
Indeed it would.
I'll send the stuff on to Mid when it comes in.
Thank you, Karen. That just leaves the carpenter. Let's see if Bardolph's available.
Well, don't just stand there gawping. Quite the opposite. Like father, like daughter. Go on, then. You'll not find a better price than that. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. Finished, are you?
Welcome back, Sid. Oh, keep your mug handy.
Oh, Maeve knows how to brew a bitter, all right.
I expect this place will be sprouting wings soon enough, then.
Tome says he's looking for books about Torgal. I know. Let's run.
When we find out anything about Torgal, you'll be the first to know.
What do you need? Summer storm, that one. What's that for you, dear? Should last you a good while. Not bad, if I do say so myself. Yeah, that should do ya. Thank you.
That it? Fine. Clive. Sangfornian, dear. And how am I meant to do that then?
And what can I do for you? Go on then. And be thankful you got that much. Finished, are you?
It's all right. See, there's nothing to fear.
Jill looked white as a sheet when they brought her back. I dread to think what happened in Rosalith. The Littlins have been up to their old tricks again. Drawing on the Deccan this time.
Shirley's got her work cut out keeping them in line.
Yeah. What's everyone whispering about?
Haven't you heard?
I heard.
Mid's back.
Mid's building a workshop down in the stalls, is she? I suppose space is the one thing we do have down there. If she wants to take it over, it's no skin off my nose.
Should be enough to keep us going. How do, Master Cid?
Bardolph. Mid's looking to build a workshop in the storeroom, and she needs the aid of a skilled carpenter. So naturally I thought of you.
Well, I'd love to help the young miss however I can. But I'm afraid I got my hands full just keeping this place afloat. There's holes need patching, and if I don't patch them, we'll all of us sink into the mere. I'd gladly spare Mid all the time I have, but the sad truth is, I ain't got none.
I see.
It don't have to be me, though, does it? What about that other fella? You know, the one over at Martha's Rest. Bernard, was it?
That's right. And he is a friend of the cause. I'll ask Martha if she can spare him. Thank you, Bardolph.
Least I could do. That Bernard's as good a carpenter as you'll find, by all accounts. I reckon my old master would have preferred his work to mine. But we branded can't be beaten on price, can we?
faster.
Straight home now.
Farewell! Dead now. Whatever it was.
Stay sharp. We don't know when those bastards will be back.
Martha tells me you and your friends drove the Dalmex out of Rosalith. You're a true hero, Sid.
Thank you for sticking with us.
How do you? There you go. Thanks very much. Much obliged. Thanks very much.
Aid when the Republicans attacked. I'd have been running in the opposite direction, as fast as my poor legs would carry me.
Ah, Clive, what brings you to the rest?
Our home finds itself in need of an extra carpenter. I wondered if I might be able to borrow Bernard for a short while.
I don't mind if he don't. We're all friends here, aren't we?
Thank you, Martha. Do you know where I might find him?
He went up to Cressida on business. No idea what, mind. Place is a ruin. Far as I know, he's still there.
I'll look from there, then.
Don't ask me what Bernard's doing in Cressida. He'll have his reasons, though, I'm sure.
Get it, boy!
Not but wild beasts, this end. All their twisted talons and gruesome maws used to turn my stomach. That was before I heard about the Black Shields.
Yeah!
If it ain't the lad who saved my life. What brings you to a place like this?
You do, Bernard. Martha said I might find you here. I have a proposition for you.
Oh, do you now? Building a workshop, you say? Well, that beats tacking boards to bridges, sure enough. And if Martha didn't mind me being gone a while, then neither do I. You just tell me where you want me.
That's the spirit.
I couldn't ask a favor, though, could I? before we go?
Of course.
Well, that there is Cressida, where I grew up. Ain't much left of it now, though. Except my parents' graves. But I came up here hoping to visit. I even patched up the bridge to get across. Only to find the place crawling with fiends. But you're a dab hand when it comes to dealing with beasts and bogles, ain't you? Any chance you could,
It's the least I can do.
Well, thank you kindly. And take care. I'd be much obliged if you could rid the old place of nasties. And so would my ma and pa, I'm sure.
This shouldn't take long. That should do it.
You made short work of that lot. Thank you, son. Now my folks can rest in peace once more.
How long is it since the village was abandoned?
Well, people started packing their things after the duchy fell. Between the Blight and the Imperials, you just couldn't make ends meet. Must be nigh on a decade since the last wagon left. Though it may as well have been a century, looking at the place. This isn't the Cressida I remember.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. Can't live in the past, no matter how nice it might have been. Soon as I'm done saying a prayer for those that raised me, it's onto your hideaway. I'll meet you there.
That should take care of Mid's little list. Better head back before she thinks of anything else.
Jill looked white as a sheet when they brought her back.
Clive? What do you want? Anything else?
It's all right.
How's it coming along?
You were born in Rosalith, weren't you?
Must be hard, hearing what became of the place.
But I want to help Miss Middidal with her experiments.
And you can, as soon as you finish solving those equations.
Then?
I am. I've placed your various orders, and a carpenter by the name of Bernard is on his way from Arthur's Rest.
That's brilliant! Thanks, Clive.
Is there anything else you need?
Nope. Blackthorn and Lady Karen have already sent over everything I asked for, and I've got all my plans drawn up. So as soon as Bernard gets here, we can get to work. I can't wait!
That's my good deed for the day done. Let's see how Jill's faring.
Did Bernard say how long he was going to be? I mean, it's fine, but I hope he comes soon.
Shouldn't you be getting some rest soon?
Thank you, Sid. Coming back to us.
The little ones have been up to their old tricks again. Drawing on the...
Do you have a moment, Sid? A team of curse breakers has gone missing near Northreach.
Which team?
Coles. They were sent to liberate a carriage of bearers before they could be smuggled to market. They were moving in for their assault when the carriage was attacked by goblins. A Cursebreaker managed to release a Stolas amid the confusion, but... this was days ago. They should be back by now, but I've heard nothing from any of them. I can't help but worry that...
they know the work is dangerous. But I'm sure they're fine.
But what if I've got them all killed? Before they go out, I always remind them why we're doing this, what they escaped, and what we're freeing people from. But I never really thought how my words might affect them. What risks they might take because of the things I've said.
I'll go and find them. We'll both rest easier knowing they're safe.
Thank you, Cid. And I'm sorry to trouble you with this. The plan was to intercept the slaver somewhere in the Dragon's Eyrie. I can't tell you much more than that, I'm afraid.
That should be enough to go on. If they were there, Torgal will track them down.
We're lucky that Stolas escaped the Dragon's Eyrie unscathed. Without it, we would never even have known that Cole's team had been attacked.
What's everyone whispering about?
Haven't you heard?
Been doing Mid's bidding, have you? Yeah, she's wrote me in and all. Mammy promised to sweep the old blooming cellar for her. Jill.
Recovering, but she still needs her rest.
Of course. Take good care of her, won't you?
I'll do my best. Oh, Gav was looking for you. He said he had something to show you in the shelves.
The shelves? Oh, that's right. He went to ask Harpocrates about Torgor. He must have found something.
Don't keep Gav waiting. He seemed excited.
You have the look of a man with the twins upon his shoulders, Rodrigue.
Taya has tasked me with removing a Cursebreaker's brand. But it's my first time, and I don't think I can do it. I'm afraid of what happens if I fail. You survived, I know, but near as many die as recover. Is it really worth the risk?
You don't need me to answer that. You know full well what we're fighting for. I hope as much as you that one day bearers can walk among others as equals. But until that day, a brand is a burden, and we must lift that burden in order to go undetected. The operation may be dangerous, but it's also essential, and we undergo it willingly.
I know. I still wish there was some other way. Griping about my lot helps no one, I suppose. Don't worry. I'll do what must be done.
I know you will.
Unfortunately, the first thing that needs doing is the preparation of a draught to dull the pain. Something I can't do with the infirmary's ammonia supply so low. What few leaves we have would barely be enough for removing a splinter, let alone a brand.
Just tell me what you need.
You'll go? Oh, thank you. No one knows Herblore like Taya, and she swears by ammonia for easing pain. It's simple enough to find, if you know where to look. And fortunately for you, I do. Along the river near the village of Amber over in Rosaria. Just search for the bright blue blossoms. If we could get ammonia to grow here in the hideaway, We wouldn't have to risk our lives to gather it.
I'm feeling a lot better, thanks to Taya's remedies. But she insists I rest.
Slavers don't even bother with the fridge now or the height.
Let's go. Straight home now.
Cole, I'm glad you're in one piece.
Just about. Sid, if you don't mind me asking, what are you doing here?
Doris sent me to find you. She hasn't heard anything since the attack. She's been worried about you.
I sent a runner to the Dame in Northreach. The Hideaway should have learned of our survival yesterday.
Well, I'm here now. And it looks like you freed the bearers.
Only some. The rest locked themselves in the slavers' carriage rather than fleeing when they had the chance. I want to help them, Sid. But we're barely in any state to protect those few we did save.
You made the right decision. Now where's the carriage?
The goblins may still be out there.
You have duties to attend to here. See to the injured. I'll handle the rest.
All right. Just follow the path to the south. You'll come across the carriage soon enough. And please, hurry. If the beastmen get to those bearers, the poor souls will be eaten alive.
I won't let that happen.
Thank you. And Sid, it's good to see you.
Don't thank me just yet.
When the goblins drove off the slaver's guard, I thought they might be doing us a favor. Damn fool.
Come on.
Faster.
They're trying to get into the carriage.
Waken wins!
This one.
Nice try.
Who are you?
A friend. Are there any more survivors? Why didn't you flee with the others? If the goblins had made it through that door, you wouldn't have stood a chance.
Why should we run? One miserable death's no worse than another.
Perhaps. But we're here to give you another choice. Freedom, safety, the life you've been denied. Come with us. Let us protect you.
Sid, I couldn't just let you... You weren't too late then. Thank the gods.
This man risked his life to save yours. To give you a second chance.
Fine. Do with us what you will.
What we'll do with you is take you to safety. After that, it's up to you. Your lives are your own now.
You can leave the rest to us, Sid. We'll get everyone back to the hideaway.
Thank you. I'll let Doris know we're expecting new arrivals.
My team needs proper medical attention, but we'll get our new companion settled first.
Why risk your lives to free the likes of us? What could you possibly gain?
Was easy enough to find. Now for those herbs. The only plant around here with blue flowers. I hope it's the right one. Should be enough to keep the infirmary stocked for a while. Hopefully this will put Rodriguez's mind at ease.
I've made up my mind. I'm joining the garrison.
There was a time my husband might have stood up to those men.
soldiers closed their gates to all but the Highborn, and now a great camp.
Garrison's always looking for new men, you know.
The Littlins have been up to their old tricks again.
Sid, welcome back. Astolis from the Dame arrived not long after you left. If I'd just waited a little longer, I might have been able to deal with things myself. Or maybe I wouldn't. I keep making the wrong decisions.
Cole and the others got home safely. You made exactly the right decision.
No, I was lucky. I've been tracking that slaver for months, and then I sent Cole and you after them, woefully unprepared. What kind of leader sends people into danger without considering all the risks? I should have urged greater caution, told Cole to be wary, to pull back at the first sign of trouble.
We swore the same oath as you, Doris.
It's good to see you safe and well, Cole. I'm sorry.
With all due respect, we Cursebreakers don't risk our lives because you commanded of us. We risk them because we believe in our cause. No one with doubts ever joins our ranks. The agony of removing the brand more than sees to that.
We all know how much bravery that takes.
Cole, I never doubted your courage. Only my ability to see it put to good use. Thank you for your faith in me. I'm not sure I deserve it. I sometimes wonder if I might prefer to risk death alongside the others than ask it of them. But I'm a Cursebreaker. I swore an oath too. I have a role to play, and I must trust that I'm the right one to play it.
You will. In time.
Miss Brynham.
I didn't mean to doubt my comrades, but I couldn't leave them out there either. I need to trust them more, I see that. But that doesn't mean I need to care about them any less.
I hope you didn't have too much trouble finding the ammonia.
Only the usual.
Oh, yes. This is it. And more than I was expecting. I dare say the patient won't feel a thing. That is, unless I...
You'll do fine. Taya trusts you. Which means I trust you. The hideaway would be lost without skilled physicians like yourself.
Thank you for the kind words. Truly. But... I'm sorry. I'm still terrified. The brand is more than just ink on flesh. It's a death sentence. Milk of the wyvern tail lurking just below the surface of the skin. One ill-conceived incision, a single slip, and the poison fouls the patient's blood. Failure means death, and even success means tremendous pain. Days of agony as the wound heals. I became a physicker to help people, not to kill them. I don't want to kill anyone.
Cursebreakers lead hard lives. And the operation is only the beginning. They toil in the shadows, risking life and limb. Knowing their efforts will win them neither glory nor acclaim. And yet we never won for volunteers. Why do you think that is?
Conviction? They're willing to die?
They're willing to fight. To give their lives to create a world where people like us can be more than mere possessions. I know your work isn't easy, but neither is going under the knife. Be a shoulder for your patients to lean on. Stay strong for them.
You sound like Tyre. Do you know what she once told me? It's natural for a patient to feel like they're suffering in solitude. And it's a physicist's duty to see that they don't. Thank you for helping me remember that. I won't falter. Not again. I'm sorry I let my fear get the better of me. I'm ready to be stronger. For the hideaway. For all of us.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Here's everything we've received and everything promised. Here you are. Best of luck out there, Sid.
Here. What's everyone whispering about?
The little ones have been up to their old tricks again. Jill looks white as a sheet.
Clive, where have you been? I've been wanting to ask you something about Torgal. Where did you get him, like, in the first place?
My father brought him back from one of his expeditions into the Northern Territories. They were crossing a snowfield when they heard his cries, and seeing no sign of his pack, they took him in.
What do you reckon, Tones?
It certainly adds weight to the theory. Clive, I believe that Torgal may be no mere hound, but a rare frostwolf, an animal native to the far northern reaches of Valisthea. In one of our oldest bestiaries, I found reference to a frostwolf who served as guardian to an ancient queen of the north. Such was his mastery over ether, he could cast magics on command. His name was Fenrir.
Fenrir the Frostwolf.
Now, the annals do not state it explicitly, but I have reason to believe this queen was a dominant of Shiva, a girl from the Northern Territories and her faithful hound. One awakens as the dominant of Shiva, and the other?
You're saying that Jill granted Torgal his powers?
What?
Just like Fenrir. People called him my hound, but Torgal and Jill were inseparable. He grew up as a faithful companion to the dominant of Shiva, and years later, his powers awakened, just when his master needed him the most.
You're right. If it weren't for Torgal blasting those bastards to kingdom come, Jill would have been for it.
Quite. Though Torgal's power is his own, his latent birthright as a frostwolf, it had only to be unlocked.
Oh, get you, Torgal!
You're an even finer hound than we thought.
And regarding your original concern, you need not fear for Torgal's health. Why, the beast has the appetite of a behemoth. Just this very morn, I found him with his nose buried in my nuts.
There you are! I've been looking everywhere for you. Bernard's here. I need you to introduce us so we can get to work.
I shall be a moment.
brilliant.
It is.
Well, I couldn't have done it without you. You and everyone else. But I promise I'll pay you back. I'm going to work my fingers to the bone for you lot. Starting right now. Just you wait. I'll make wonders like this world's never seen.
Then I look forward to seeing them. Now that that's settled, I wonder if Vivian's made any progress tracking down Kupka.
Thanks for before, son. That was a good deed you did me. Only right I do you one in return. Though I did wonder if I'd bit off more than I could chew when Mid showed me her plans for the place. If she hadn't been there to tell me what to do, I wouldn't have known where to start.
We have everything we need to begin work in earnest.
And work in earnest we shall!
Thanks for letting me do this, Clive. I'll pay you back, I promise.
I wish Miss Midador would let us help her with her dungeoneering. I wonder what she's going to dungeoneer next.
Let's go and ask her.
Till Mid's away to take a tour of her dungeon. Don't want to get roped into her experiments.
Finally got Mid out of your hair, have you? Enjoy the quiet. Doubt it'll last long.
How goes the hunt for Kupka?
Largely in circles. We have myriad sightings of strange soldiers in unexpected places, but nothing definitive as yet. If only we knew for certain by what route he left Rosalith.
Well, keep at it. If anyone can piece this puzzle together, it's you. And I'm willing to wait as long as it takes.
What? Here?
Would that be a problem?
Do you know, Clive, I believe it a mercy that you didn't inherit your father's throne. Your poor people would surely live in fear of you.
You have nothing to worry about on that front. I won't be claiming his crown.
That is a relief.
Clive, have you got a minute? We, have a guest.
A guest?
For your trouble.
It was a pleasure, in hindsight.
Uncle Byron?
Clive, my boy! Tap a cask and stoke the ovens for your favorite uncle is here!
Dalmechian government sues for peace. How shall we respond?
If they're willing to accept their fault in the matter, I see no reason to refuse them.
Still, we must insist on substantial reparations. Twinside stores are not as bottomless as reported.
Aye, and we have many more mouths to feed. We shall just have to have the Dalmecs empty their treasuries for us.
Of course, none of this would have been possible without your timely intervention, Prince Olivier.
Indeed, I doubt any of us would have had the courage to trade words with the mighty Titan, nor less the wit to win him over.
The Empire owes you a great debt.
May the blessing of the crystals go with you, Your Highness.
May the blessing of the crystals go with you.
Very good.
Now, let us come to the question of precisely when the Dalmecs will withdraw their troops.
Dion's fire could rid us of them in mere moments. The men of the Fist will not withdraw until a peace treaty is concluded. So let us keep the negotiations open, give them time to gather what gold and trinkets they can. And once they deliver that which we demand, what worth is a piece of parchment?
Your Radiance, were Prince Dion to take the field, the enemy would surely send their own dominant to meet him. And while His Highness would, of course, prevail, there would be heavy losses on both.
You need not fear Hugo Kupka. He is engaged on the Western Front. Even were the Dalmecs to send for him, he would not arrive in time. As much as I would enjoy witnessing a clash between Bahamut and Titan, it is not to be.
And what of your subjects, Your Radiance? If the fighting spread to the city proper, the people would bear the brunt of it.
There will be losses, it is true. Yet for every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built. The Empire will live on. Dion?
Yes, sir.
Prepare for battle.
But, sire...
Do not make me repeat myself. Return to your camp and await my orders.
If that is your wish, Your Radiance, I shall depart at once.
Do the astrologers augur?
The stars are in agreement, Your Radiance. The shadow of treachery hangs over Prince Dion.
So Annabella's tales were true. You disappoint me, Dion.
earth is Uncle Byron doing here? Only one way to find out.
The Littlins have been up to their old tricks.
There's just one thing after another around here.
Well, fuck me. Never thought I'd see the dear Lord Byron Rosfield of the Seven High Houses came to tea.
Ah, my dear nephew, how I've missed you.
How did you find this place, Uncle?
Through the good offices of young Sir Wayne. He really is the most helpful fellow. As are you, I hear. The guardians and those they freed tell the most outlandish tales of your heroics in Rosalith. Which is why I came, to learn the full truth of the matter. Sort the fact from the fiction, so to speak.
You were working with the Guardians of the Flame to evacuate the people of Rosalith to Port Isolde.
I was, aye.
Then I have questions for you. Please, come inside, Uncle.
Gladly. You there? There are 2,000 gold talents in those chests. See that they're added to my nephew's coffers, would you?
2,000?
And I'm afraid that is all I know.
A fleet sailing south past Port Isolde. Most intriguing.
Forgive me for not being able to tell you more. I hadn't the faintest idea Kupka withdrew wounded from Rosalith. Still less that my own nephew dealt the decisive blow.
What do you think, Vivian?
I think, with this news of the Dalmechian fleet and recent reports of the Royalists' movements, that the final piece of the puzzle has fallen into place. Come here and I'll show you. It is known that Kupka's forces entered Rosaria via its unguarded coast. So can the same be said of your visitors from Wulud? Certainly, her Royal Navy is famed for the efficiency with which it bears her knights from one battlefield to the next. And in the Ein Herjar, or Black Galleon, she boasts a vessel nigh as swift and every bit as feared as the kingdom's legendary cavalry. A fitting flagship for a land apart, her naval presence being crucial to her ambitions beyond Ash. Yes, it seems safe to assume that the Royalists did indeed enter Rosaria from the sea. So then, had you a vested interest in Titan's survival, whither would you take him? Why, home to Drake's Fang, a place rich enough in ether to conjure the magics needed to mend his hurts. But would that not entail an arduous voyage around the Southern Cape? Let us say that the Royalists did put ashore with a mind to spirit Kupka away from under your very nose. Could that truly have been their plan for him? To load him aboard one of the ships flying Republican colors sighted off the coast near Port Isolde. To spend weeks at sea, being tossed hither and yon by unforgiving waves, his life hanging in the balance. No. The journey would mean Titan's death, and Kupka's faithful creatures would not allow it. So what then was the plan of our Waluda friends? Reports suggest they made not for the coast, but for the desert. And by cutting through the Velcroi, A party traveling light would have Titan back in his bed days before a galley could lurch into port. To wit, it was the Royalists, not the Republicans, who effected Hugo Kupka's safe retreat. I would stake your life on it.
So it was the Walludas who spirited the wretch away. Now I think about it, there was something a little strange about the ships I saw. The men seemed almost crestfallen, as if in mourning, as if they believed, or were made to believe, that their master was dead.
You have a keen mind, Lord Rosfield. And you have your answer. To find Kupka, you have merely to follow the Royalist trail across the Velcroy. It may well have gone cold by now, but as they say in the Republic, all roads lead to Drake's Fang.
Allow me to accompany you part of the way. As luck would have it, I had intended to journey Canberward on business after visiting you here. The Fang would be but a short detour.
I'd be glad of the company. Give me a moment to make ready. I need to tell my friends what we've learned, and where we're going.
Very well, but be quick about it, my boy. Time waits for no man.
Here for another of my lectures. Lord Byron Rosfield. I heard tell. Why? Your nemesis awaits, Clive. You have merely to cross a burning desert, then worm your way into the bowels of an enemy fortress. Best of luck. Ah, my favorite people. Of course. Study it well, Clive. The state of the realm is ever-changing.
And how may I assist you to...
Very good.
Mid's finished outfitting her little workshop, I hear.
With a little help from Sid, of course.
Of course. Our new leader's no better at resisting her wheedling than the old one was.
Jill's staying here, and that's that. I should have never let her go with you to Rosalith.
I'm fine, Clive, really. I just need some rest.
Otto. Kupka's at Drake's Fang. I'll be leaving before sunset.
You're not going in there alone, are you?
Don't worry. I'm not going there to destroy the Mother Crystal. All I'm after is Kupka's head. I won't risk any more than I have to. I promise.
The lands around the Fang are all Kupka's personal fiefdom. You have any trouble on the way, you ask for Rosina Dalimil. Some call her the Desert Hare.
Who is she?
An old associate of Sid's, and only Sid's. All I know is the name, and that they used to meet at the Dalimil Inn. We've heard nothing from her since he died. But I'm thinking maybe the new Sid might be able to bring her back into the fold.
Thanks. I'll keep that in mind.
So, what about your uncle? I mean, he's welcome to stay, but...
Don't look so worried. He'll be coming with me.
Thank fuck for that.
Gav, Otto, I'm leaving you two in charge.
You can count on us. I heard they call Rosina the Desert Hare on account of how little escapes her ears. That and her habit of bolting at the first sight of danger. But if she knew Sid was looking for her, she might just be tempted back out of her burrow.
What's wrong, Gav?
It's this gold your uncle gave us. Are you sure it's all right for us to take it?
My uncle isn't easily refused, especially where dispersing his wealth is concerned.
But 2,000 talents? I don't even know how much that is in Gil.
It's the price of a quayside mansion in the Crystalline Dominion. He sold one to fund our endeavor. He was hoping to part with it anyway, what with war brewing in the region. And, luckily for him, a Sambraquan noble was willing to pay over the odds for a foothold in the Holy Emperor's neighborhood.
But still, 2,000 talents! I mean, is it normal for nobles to give away that kind of money?
It's normal for my uncle.
Fuck me. Oh, the other half live, eh?
Well, now that we've got a few gil to rub together, do you think it'd be all right if I splashed out on a few bottles of Lostwing's finest?
Here, leave some for the rest of us, Otto. If he's filling his cellar, I'm filling our larder, starting with a barrel of the best salt-cured northern salmon.
I'll leave you to decide how best to use it. Just don't spend all at once. All right.
I've never seen a crate full of gil before, let alone two. Your uncle certainly knows how to make an entrance.
The Littlans have been up to their old tricks again.
All right, Uncle. I'm ready to depart. Shall we?
We shall. Come, let us away to adventure.
Citizens are free to come and go as they please. Checkpoint's open to all. Citizens are free to come and go as they please. Checkpoint's open to all. You'll find a little beyond Northreach, though. When the throne moves south, most with any sense followed.
Did you hear? The gates to Heaven Hall in the Aerie were breached by someone. Or something. The steward was in town earlier looking for men to come and repair it. But no one was keen to help.
I want to see you again tonight. But the captain's late with our pay.
It's all right. I'll be waiting.
What am I going to do without sweet water and oil of talc?
Still no caravan from the Dominion's perfumeries yet, then.
Seeing as business is scarce these days, the Dame decided we should all learn to read. I only wish she had some smaller books. My arms ache something fierce.
Time was there were great coin sacks swinging from every belt in town. Not anymore. Since the capital moved, they're all shriveled to the size of peas.
It's been too long. The realm may have changed. I will admit, I fancy yours, meanwhile. Before there was a Northreach. But alas. Not everyone left the capital. In a few short moons, the veil does what it can. Do stay out of trouble.
We should find a caravan south. Look, there's still time.
I sent to the capital for a new bearer weeks ago, but I haven't heard a word since.
It's almost as if they've forgotten us here.
So the gold owed its luster to the great mother's light. Mark the sighing of the meadows as the day tonight.
I want that forge as hot as a demon's arsehole, or you're all getting new brands.
What's the point in patrolling? The bands have all followed the coin to Twinside.
You want a spot on the Dominion walls? You'll need to do better than that!
Not many travellers heading north these days. What with the fields barren and the penitent's gate closed.
Run like the wind.
Haven't had a decent night.
If you're looking for a meal and a bed, I suggest you continue up the road to Northridge. You'll find little here but dust and despair, and certainly none of the bounty these parts once offered.
20 years we served that man, and this is the thanks we get. I hope the bastard chokes on a bowl of fucking desert porridge.
I've got nothing to sell you, traveller. Barely enough for ourselves.
There was a time this place would have been stacked high with sacks of rye and barley and spelt. Then Drake's head vanished, and our livelihoods with it. Now all we have are memories.
Who does he think he is? Making me sweep up like a bloody branded.
Crystal cracked, so did the preacher, stopped giving sermons. And then one day he was just gone.
Ready, girl?
Away, traveller. The penitent's gate remains closed by order of the Imperial Throne.
We watch over a corpse that does not yet know it's dead. The least we can do is see it is not defiled any further.
Let's go.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Deserve a rest.
Good day to you.
wizard.
But when can I go on a special errand for Master Quinton?
Use a crystal instead.
I'll be fine. Besides, the village can't be using its last few crystals to do its dirty laundry, can it?
You're quite talented with that rod of yours.
I've caught my share with it, as did my grandfather before me. We get from the tailor all but worthless.
It's not just the crystals. Bearers are having trouble with their magics as well.
It's all but spent. What do we do now?
Sid, just say the word. I'll have a bed made up while you eat, and that goes for your friends too.
Are we going to dig a new cellar to store all the unsold barrels?
If too many barrels is your problem, I reckon I could lend a hand.
Good to see you, Sid, as always. Master Quinton's out back.
Are you even listening?
If we're to sup on sour news, let it be over sweet wine.
Wench! Another round!
Hello, Sid. Take a seat where you like.
And what brings you to the Hanged Man today? Lest you wonder. Yes. If you must know. However, regrettably, until next time, Sid.
Ready those three barrels round the front. They're to go on the caravan south.